again. Oh, but it's not a good idea.
Oh, Ben was right. We should not have drunk Harold's nasty medicine.
He didn't. I changed it to Bet's blood. Your fault.
How'd you work that out?
Well, if you weren't thinking about food all the time, then we wouldn't have stolen that treacle tart. If you hadn't stolen the treacle tart, then have stolen Harold's nasty medicine.
I was hungry.
You're always hungry.
No, I'm not. Oh, no. What have we got?
Four spiders, two wood lice, and half a dozen or so bats.
Three spiders.
Oh, gee, that's pathetic.
Rooms indeed. Oh, disappearing treacle tarts. And if anyone thinks I'm going to be fazed by that, they've got another thing coming. They'll soon see what it's like to be up against a bag meanly.
Neat trick, Harold.
Oh, what a fright. I thought you were Violet. She's on the warpath, you know. She's even hidden my glasses.
Why?
So she can creep up on me.
I just want to be home. In our cave, my own bed. With Binbag bringing me soothing little snacks.
All you need to do is get out. Cheer ourselves up a bit. Retail therapy, perhaps. Stock up on all those little necessities that make life worth living.
Shopping? I don't know. Ben's angry with us enough as it is.
Yeah, but all we need is a reason to go outside. Got it.
We can say we're getting some ingredients to make Harold some more medicine. It's a perfect couple. I don't know. Ben really scares him when he's angry.
Sometimes I wonder if you were swapped at spawn and you're not a real witch at all.
Out of my way, you clumsy oaf.
It's good morning to you, Mrs. Bagman.
I wouldn't be at all surprised if you weren't at the bottom of all these goings-on. Well, don't think you can pull the wool over my eyes. I'm going to get to the bottom of it. And when I do, it's going to be bye-bye, Ben Babbicorn.
Violet!
Well, I think I'll just pop over to the church for a bit. You know, things to do, people to see.
What people to see and things to do? I'll give you things to do.
Tell us off again.
I've come to warn you that World War III has broken out at the vicarage and Mrs. Bagmeanley's ready for action.
Not scared of her.
Well, you should be. She's terrifying. And if she finds you here, then you're going to be out of here so fast that... Well, look, anyway, just do yourselves a favour and stay in here for a bit. I'll come and let you know when the coast is clear, OK?
Sorry about...
No, no, you're not, are you? It's always the same. You're always sorry afterwards, aren't you?
Mum!
Look, stop lying, Chris. I know you were there. You were seen running away.
Okay, I admit it. I was there, but I didn't do it.
Well, what's this, then? A figment of my imagination?
Sorry, Mum, but you've got to believe me.
And where did you get this paint? It won't come off. I've washed Constable Bloater's Long John's 3 times now, and it just won't budge. They're ruined. I tell you, Christopher Tucker, if I end up having to replace them, the money's coming out of your pocket money. Do you understand? Right. Now I'm going to work. Try and stay out of trouble. And tidy this room of yours. It's a pit.
They're going to kill those witches.
I hope you remembered all the ingredients for the medicine.
Yeah, well, if I have, we can improvise.
Oh, right, yeah, it's just like you did with Detagrog's sister that time.
That was ages ago. I don't know what the fuss was about.
You turned her into a mouse and you got eaten by a cat spy.
Yeah, well, I was young and foolish.
No change there, then.
Right, on three.
One, two, three. Three.
Ben's really angry with us.
What am I supposed to do about that? Go on. If my mum sees you, she'll go crazy.
But it's really important. And Ben told us not to leave the Belfry.
Go back there, then.
Rushy, did you get up here before someone sees you?
You all right?
No. But I might be if you help me.
Oh, please, it's really important.
If we replace Harold's nasty medicine, then... perhaps we'll be allowed out again.
You took Harold Snelling's medicine?
Yeah.
Harold's nasty medicine? Do you know how dangerous that could have been?
It wasn't dangerous by the time we changed it into bat's blood.
Look, are you going to help us or not?
I wish I could, but I can't. I promised my mum.
Hey, I think someone's coming.
Bye, Mum.
Bye.
Well?
Bye. All right, just don't let her see you. And I've got two conditions.
Name them.
First, if I help you put things right with Ben, then you've got to help me put things right with my mum.
Next?
No flying. If I have to walk, then you have to walk.
Deal.
Don, you know what happens to me when I have to walk anywhere.
What?
Well, don't ask.
Well, those are the conditions. Take them or leave them.
They take them.
Promise?
Absolutely, positively. Was she?
Oh, all right. Like a frog and newt's eye, cross my heart and I hope to die.
Ah! Constable Bloater! Just the man I want to see!
Mrs. Bagminley. Before you start, it's my afternoon off, and as you can see, I'm going fishing.
I want to know what you're doing about all these strange goings-on.
I'm not certain as to what strange goings-on you are conferring. However, at this precise moment, I am not doing anything, seeing as how I'm off duty. I'm sure whatever these strange things are, they can wait for an hour or two.
They most certainly cannot. This is a matter for the police. Are you or are you not a policeman?
No. At this precise moment, I am an off-duty policeman. Now, if you'd like to come back this afternoon...
This afternoon? The world as we know it is falling about around our ears, and you tell me to come back this afternoon?
Good day, Mrs. Bagmanley.
I've a good mind to report you to your superiors.
Right, where's that bag? Now, first things first. What exactly is wrong with Harold?
Don't know. Always looks really well to me. A bit thin.
Well, perhaps all he needs is a tonic. Give him a bit of zip.
Oh, I could do with some of that.
What about my mum? What are we going to make her?
Well, I thought perhaps we could make her some of our famous bubble bath.
Oh, she'd love that.
It won't turn her into a frog or anything, will it?
No, don't be silly. Just make her smell nice.
It'll give her bubbles like she has never seen before.
All right. Bubble bath is then. Strawberry's her favourite.
Ew. I was thinking more of the lines of sort of mould and mildew.
With a base note of fungus.
You can't give her that.
Well, we'll grow on her.
It's strawberry. I'm going home.
Oh, right, strawberry it is. But you're going to have to pick all the smelly things.
Oh.
Right, let's get cracking. I think it'll be quicker if we split up. Noshi, you're on dandelion roots, worms and frog spawn. Chris, you're on snails and maggots.
Maggots?
Yeah, what else is there?
Owl droppings.
You have got to be kidding.
Well, it's either that or a hair from a bull's tail.
massacre.
Or a cat's verbal.
You've persuaded me. I'll do the air droppings.
Right then, that's sorted. We're rendezvous here. And Noshi, be careful of the humans. Don't know which ones can see us yet. Oh, Ben. I wanted to thank you for yesterday. I don't normally go in for fainting.
This is Polly. Are you feeling better?
Well, don't ask. I don't know what to do with him. Last night was the final straw.
Why, what happened?
Well, he ruined Constable Bloater's washing. Covered it in some kind of paint. He denies it, of course. That's what hurts the most. All these lies.
Perhaps he's telling the truth.
He was seen.
What, actually doing it?
No, running away.
I think I'd run if Constable Bloater were after me. Chris is a good lad. Perhaps you should give him the benefit of the doubt.
Do you know what, Ben? You are a very nice man.
Babacorn?
Still here? I thought you were going into town to get Harold some more medicine.
I was just leaving.
Well, what's keeping you?
Bye, Ben. And thanks.
Mrs. Tucker, I want to talk to you.
About what?
Something very odd is happening, and I aim to get to the bottom of it, so... Babacorn? Tell me about your missing door. And did you see anybody?
Wind come forth and up you blow, so that human underwear show.
Oh, what a strong wind. You've all been most helpful. Once I have collated all the information, I shall be taking it to Constable Bloater to investigate.
Cat. Anyway, at least it was stagnant water, getting worse, being fresh. Oh, you smell lovely.
Oh, I know. Ball put up a bit of a fight. It was close, but in the end, he was no match for me.
Thank you.
Anyway, I think we could do with a brewing utensil or two.
Cauldron for our cooking spell, appear before us to make things well.
You got everything?
Yes, we good.
I think you've done this before.
No, I haven't.
Oh, like we all believe you.
maggots.
Oh, Noshi, no. If you want some, you go and get your own.
I thought I might find you here.
Would you mind keeping your voice down? You're scaring the fish.
Maybe you'll take me seriously if I show you this.
What's that?
Proof. Documented evidence that nearly everyone in the village has experienced strange phenomena in the last couple of days. Television aerials twisted off. Cars covered in egg yolk. Brooms and brushes falling from the sky. I could go on. The list is endless. I want to make a formal statement.
You can't do that here.
No, but we can back at the station.
Mrs. Bagnigley, it may be difficult to apprehend, but I am still off duty.
Then I shall wait.
Hear it back at the station.
Perfect.
Are they ready?
Yep, just need to put them in.
I can do that. Our potions need the finest glass, shaped in the bottles of the highest class. See you again.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Goodbye. Oh, Chris, I'm so glad you're here. I wanted to talk to you.
Mom, I'm really sorry about...
I'm sorry. Oh, come here.
Oh, Mom!
I should have believed you. If you said you had nothing to do with what's been going on, then that's good enough for me.
I've got you this.
Oh. Oh, what a lovely bubble.
It's strawberry bubble bath. Oh,
thank you. And you know what? I'm going to shut up shop early today and go home and have a nice, long soak.
Can't do magic here. Ben might see. Won't budge.
No, you won't fit through it anyway.
So now what are we going to do?
Good afternoon, ladies. Can I help?
Is he talking to us?
Are you friends of Ben's?
Yeah, we are, as a matter of fact.
Jolly good. Any friend of Ben's a friend of mine. Come here and make yourselves at home. Would you like some tea?
Oh, yes, please. Oh,
Harriet, what are you playing at?
He's really nice. Doesn't know how to be friendly.
I'm afraid this may take some time. I mislaid my glasses. I wonder, can you see them anywhere? Beginning to think you weren't coming.
My what?
Hi, Ben.
Hi, Ben.
Come and join us. We've been having such a jolly chat. Violet has been out all day, so we've had a chance of getting to know each other. They've even found my glasses for me.
How very nice of them. Don't you two need to be getting home soon?
Just one more cuppa.
Mrs. Bagmealy's on her way.
Oh, yeah. Of course, at the time. Bye.
What a shame. I was so enjoying your company.
Well, thank you for having us.
It was an absolute pleasure. Dear boy, is there anything the matter?
No, why?
You were being uncharacteristically rude to those charming young ladies.
That Constable Bloater is totally useless. However, I finally managed to persuade him to take note of the overwhelming evidence.
Evidence of what?
The strange goings-on, of course. He's going to investigate the matter. And in the meantime, I'm going to get rid of the bats and the belfry.
What? You can't.
Why ever not?
Because they're a protected species.
Not from me, they're not.
Thank you.
get it. We replaced Harold's medicine and we're still stuck in it.
I told you we shouldn't stay for tea.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.